If you have any answer, we have to come forward as well. How's everybody doing? Good? How y'all doing? Okay, my first question is, everybody good today? Now, how many of you said to your mothers this morning, Happy Mother's Day? Did everybody? Alright, so if you did, you still have time today, because it's all day. You still have time to say Happy Mother's Day to your mother. Let's do that this morning. This morning, I'm going to do something a little bit different. I always do stuff kind of different. In life, we have people who always come and tell us things, right? Do people ever come and tell y'all something? Your friends come and tell you something about people? Yeah. And so, sometimes they want us to make a decision or help them make a decision. And this morning, you know, we're going to talk about asking God for wisdom, because sometimes in life, we need wisdom to be able to answer people's questions. And be able to say things in the proper way. So the reason I said I'm going to do something a little bit different this morning is, instead of me reading the whole scripture first, I'm going to tell you a story. And then I'm going to ask you, what would you do? Okay? And then you're going to tell me what you do and why you would do what you would do. Y'all understand that? So when I point or put the mic in your direction, stuff, I want you to be able to say something. Then after, we can either read the scripture or you can read the scripture at home with your parents, okay? So, in the book of James, right, it talks about wisdom, and it says that if any man lacks wisdom, right, you can ask God for wisdom. And so we're going to talk about Solomon this morning. Solomon was a young man, okay, and he could have asked God for riches, anything that he wanted. But you know what he asked God for? Because he was going to be the king of his kingdom. Do you know what he asked God for? Wisdom, right? Wisdom and how to lead God's people. So, in the book of 1 Kings, all right, so this is where I'm going. And so, you need to read this story when you get home with your parents or you want to read it yourself. 1 Kings, the third chapter, okay? I'm going to start around the 16th verse and go to the end. But I'm going to just tell you the story. I'm not going to tell you everything in the story. You know why I'm not going to tell you everything in the story? Because when people come and tell you things in life, they don't tell you the whole story. Do that? I'm just asking. Are all the grown folks sitting out there, do people come and tell you the whole story? No. So y'all heard that for yourself? So people don't come and tell you the whole story. They come and tell you what? What they want you to know about whatever, okay? So that they hope that you're on their side and you can make a decision in their favor. So they don't tell you everything. So that tells you what? That there's only sides to every story. Two. Somebody said two, or somebody said three. All right, so if there is three, all right, well, you said there's two, right? All right, so what's the two sides of the story? What are two sides of the story? Okay, and then, so that means that whoever telling the story is what? Telling the good side? Or the bad side, okay? So yes, so it's somewhere between, you know, know somebody's going to say things in their favor. So here's the story, here's the scenario this morning. There were two women who had, they were pregnant. Okay, you can read all about it. And they both had babies. And so, I believe 3 months later, what ended up happening was one of the babies ended up dying. Y'all hear me? I'm not telling the story. One of the babies ended up dying. And so one of the mothers took, when she realized that she killed her baby, she took her dead baby and went to the other lady's room and switched the baby while she was sleeping. You know the story? Okay, so if you know the story, then I'm going to tell you. I'm pretty sure most of you know the story, or some of you do, but if not, I'm just going to say it this way. So anyway, what ended up happening is they brought the baby, and the two women came before the king, who was Solomon. And so one of the ladies said, you know, that when she woke up in the morning, she went to bed with her baby, and when she woke up in the morning, and she went to give her baby, you know, some food to feed the baby, that she noticed the baby was dead, and she realized that it was not her baby. So the other lady said, no, this isn't my baby. So now you have a problem here, right? What's the problem? Who's lying? If you don't know, if she switched the baby, that's just somebody telling the story. Do you know if she switched the baby? Well, I'm saying some of y'all know the story, so you would, but I'm just saying they're not going to tell you. The lady that switched the baby ain't going to tell you she switched the baby. She ain't going to just tell you that that's her baby, okay? So anyway, here we go. So what the king did, after hearing both arguments of the story, he took a sword.
Thank you. you gotta make a decision. You got two ladies in front of you, see me? And you're making right there, right? And you gotta get the baby, one of them, or you gotta have to give her half, give her half, what would you do? Who? Huh? See, this is where you need some wisdom, right? Because somebody been in there mistake and did something wrong.
Lord, so that you would direct their path, Lord, and all the blessings we ask, Lord,